In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart.
For our Goodnight message on this Saturday, the 30th of December 2023, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University in Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this encouraging message in line with the Word of God for today, entitled Lessons from the Story of Anna, Daughter of Phanuel. Sometimes big lessons can come from short stories, like Jesus wept, the shortest verse in the Bible. Yet what it tells us is a great deal about the man he was and the God he is. Anna, what we know about her is told in three verses in today's gospel. Verse 36, 37, and verse 38. She is a prophetess. She is 84 years of age. She was married for 7 years and then her husband died. She remained a widow ever since. She stayed at the temple. She devoted to fasting and praying. And after seeing the Christ child, she began giving thanks to God. Anna would tell all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem about the Christ being born. That's a pretty impressive life. Anna shows us that a woman does not need to be married to be of use. She does not need to be married to serve the Lord. In fact, Paul says in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 32 to 34, that when it comes to dealing with persecution, being single can be beneficial. When you are single, you can put all of your focus upon the things of the Lord, like Anna did. But when you are married, you are going to be concerned about worldly things like how to please a wife or husband. We will not be given in marriage in heaven. Mark chapter 12 verse 18 to 27. When we are in the presence of God. So marriage is not a spiritual thing. It is for this world only. So if you want to be the best Christian woman you can be, maybe choosing to remain single is the best way to do that. If sexual temptation is not a very real struggle for you, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 8 to 9, then the single life is a way in which you can serve your Lord with focus and intensity that those who are married just cannot. And by saying this, I'm not discouraging anyone from marriage, but I'm talking to those who have always wanted to get married and they have not found a man to marry. I want to say it is not employment. Marriage is not employment. It is a call. It is a gift. Anna shows young widows how to give the enemy no occasion for reproach. 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 14. Having too much time on your hands is a bad thing. Paul warned Timothy about young widows who learn to be idle and fall into gossip and being busybodies because they are not focused on their work. 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 11 to 13. This is something every young woman should avoid falling into. It can be a good thing to have friends to meet with for coffee now and then. Play dates are fun, but when they keep you from taking care of the home, your husband and your children, they become an opportunity for Satan to get his foot in your door. Anna shows that your age is not an excuse. I do not know at what age she married, but the Bible makes it clear that her service from the time of her widowhood to her current age was a lengthy time. She never missed a day. Luke chapter 2 verse 37. She did not say, I'm too young and I have too much to do to serve every day. Nor did she say, after so many years of service, I'm too old now. I'm going to leave the work to the younger and more energetic. No, Anna brought her own abilities to each day of fasting and prayer. Be focused on your work. Anna was constant in her fasting and prayers. That was her life. But as we have seen with many other people already, that does not have to be what your life looks like. Be responsible. Do not be lazy. When your work is done and you have too many empty hours, find someone to do something for. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, and sweet dreams.
Same to you, Father.